Today we have with us Lenovo K8 Note, which is their next smartphone in the Note series. And in this video, we're going to do the unboxing, show you all the contents that you get, and we will be talking about its features. So here's the box. The phone will be available in two variants, 3GB RAM, 32GB storage, and this is this 4GB RAM, 64GB storage. And as you can see, Lenovo K8 Note, it comes in this green packaging. And here are some details about the device. It comes with a 5.5 inch full HD display, 13+5 dual camera on the back, deca core processor. This is X23 processor. Then you have Dolby Atmos audio support, 13 megapixel front camera, 4000 mAh battery, a dedicated music key. Then you have scratch resistant Corning Gorilla Glass and durable water repellent design. And here is the SAR value. I'm not sure if you can see it, but SAR value is not here. SAR value is here, my mistake. And the SAR value is 0.660 and 1.157 for head and body respectively. So let's unbox it and let's see what all contents do you get in the retail package of Lenovo K8 Note. So the first thing is the phone itself. Lenovo K8 Note, and there's a back cover, a clear back cover, which is already applied on the device. Let me just take that out. And this is a hard case, not a soft silica case. You can see it looks nice, and you don't need to buy a case separately. So here you can see the vertical dual camera placement, Lenovo branding, and in the front you get this 5.5 inch display on which right now there is a protector. We will be talking more about the device in a minute. Let's just quickly check out other contents present in the box. So here you get a SIM ejector pin. Then you have these manuals and warranty information. Lenovo K8 Note quick start guide. Then you get this charging adapter. And this is a 15 watt adapter. So K8 Note does support fast charging, so that's a good thing. And finally, a USB to micro USB cable for charging your smartphone. So these are the contents that you will get if you order Lenovo K8 Note smartphone. So here's the Lenovo K8 Note smartphone. Now, right now we don't know why the company skipped K7 Note, but we will try and find out about that and make a separate video soon. Talking first about the design and build quality, you get this front-facing flash on this device along with a 13 megapixel shooter. Then you have this 5.5 inch full HD display being protected by Corning Gorilla Glass 3. The viewing angles are decent and it looks like a nice display. It has good brightness level. Below that you get 3 touch buttons back, and then you have a home button and a multitasking key. On the back side you get these dual camera placement, a 13+5 megapixel shooter. The 5 megapixel is a depth sensing camera to give you those bokeh shots and blur effects. Then you have dual LED flash and fingerprint sensor. The phone comes with metal construction and it comes with a 4000 mAh battery, but still it does not feel heavy in hand. On the right side you get the power key and a volume rocker. On the left side you have interesting things. The first interesting thing is that you get two slots over here. The one contains dual nano SIM card tray, the other contains microSD card tray. So it supports dedicated microSD card. Then you have this dedicated convenience key, which can be used as a music key, or you can customize it to launch other applications as well. On the bottom side, you have one speaker, one microphone, and a micro USB port. Overall, in terms of design and build quality, the smartphone feels fine in hand, even with a big battery and big display, and the build quality feels sturdy. As mentioned, the display looks nice. It has good viewing angles and brightness level. Moving on to the hardware and the software part, the phone is being powered by a deca core processor, that's X23 processor, along with latest Android 7.1.1, and this is the stock Android experience. Our company didn't modify the UI, didn't include Vibe UI on this smartphone, so you get the stock Android experience on this particular smartphone. And it comes in two different variants. One is the 3GB RAM variant, which offers you 32GB storage. This is the 4GB RAM variant, which has 64GB storage. Out of 64GB, you roughly get around 50GB storage free and around 2.3 GB of free RAM on this particular smartphone. So depending upon your needs, if you need more storage and more RAM for more gaming and heavy multitasking, you can go with the 4 GB variant. But if you need a device with not so high RAM for multitasking and gaming purposes, then you can stick to a 3 GB variant. In terms of performance, we didn't face any lag while navigating through the interface, but we will be doing a benchmark and gaming test very soon. Moving on, let's talk about the camera. So the phone comes with a 13 megapixel front camera, and then you have a 13 plus 5 megapixel back camera. The back camera works really well, and you can see the image quality. Even after zooming in, there are a lot of details and clarity. This was taken in the depth effect mode. Again, you can see how good the object appears and the entire background is blurred. These were taken in normal mode just to test the camera quality. Again, you can zoom in and you can still read the minor text written over here, the warning text. So you can see the back camera works really well. The front camera also works well. It captures good quality selfies, and thanks to this soft LED flash, you can capture better quality selfies even in low light conditions. Now the phone comes with a 4000 mAh battery, which should give you a battery life of 1 day. A fingerprint sensor, it supports dedicated microSD card slot, and has 4G VoLTE support as well. So overall, the phone looks like a decent package, but it looks like that it can give tough competition to other smartphones under 15,000 Indian rupees present in the market. That's all for this video. So stay tuned. Thanks for watching and have a nice day.